Hi everyone, Kai here, back with another video. In today's video, we will continue making the NPC system, which specifically the dialogue system. And in case you missed part 1, I'll leave the video right in the top right corner. Let's get started. In the last episode, we created a player detection system. And now, let's make an actual UI to display our dialogue. First, create a canvas and create a text. I'm currently using the text mesh tool for a better text font, by the way, which is the TMP option right here. Create an image and rearrange it to fill the entire bottom of the screen, like that. Let's also change the color and create a text box inside it. And finally, create an empty object and name it dialogue template and drag everything in there. Also, set it to not active. Now to the scripting part. You want to create a static public variable named dialogue in the player movement script. And if it's true, we want to stop any movement, and in the camera script, you can set the camera cursor lock to false and make the cursor visible on the screen in both your FPS script like this. In the NPC system, add another statement to check if the player is not in another dialogue like that. Now to the scripting part. Let's create a function to automatically create a dialogue clone for us. And in there, let's use the instantiate function, and before that, let's get the template by first creating a public variable for it. We also want one for the canvas for later on. Back to the instantiate function, the argument needed is the object that we want to clone and its position, or its transform. So let's enter the dtemplate and dtemplate.transform. Now change its parents to canvas by doing transform.parent equal to canvas.transform, and because you can see it from the demonstration for the screen, if you don't, it will just clone outside of Canva and you can't see UI out of Canva. Back to the script, we want to get the text object and change our dialogue, so template clone.transform.getChild1, which child1 is the text box and it may change in your situation, and get component text mesh pro UI. And to get this component first, let's go to the top and write using TM Pro, which is Text Mesh Pro for short, and dot text equal to our text. And that's it. Now you have a function like so, and you will have the basic setup. So now you can enter your own dialogue like just like that. Next, let's create another script and name it to change the dialogue and put it onto our Canva. In the update method, we want to check if the left mouse is pressed and the transform.checkout of the Canva is greater than 1, which the first one is the template, so more than 1 means that we have already created a clone for it. And if the player movement.dialogue is true, then we want to open the next dialogue, and to do this, create another index variable and set the starting value to 2, and use the transform.getChildIndex and set it to true. Also increase the index every time we click so it's actually changed the dialog. If the index is equal to canvas.checkout, which is also the limit, we want to set the index to back to 2 and set the player movement of dialog to false, which is ending the dialog. And finally, if the dialogue is not true, then we want to set active the canvas to false and add an additional line in the NPC script to true. And that's it. That's the end of this video. Hope you enjoy it. Also, this is part 1 in case if you miss it, and see you guys in the next video, and hope you all a great day.